with me this morning from In Our Private Market, I'm joined by Drew Craig. Drew, good morning.
Good morning.
I've met and spoken with Rich in the past, but give us an introduction to yourself. What's your involvement?
Yes, so Rich has been to see you a couple of times now. I'm technical director with Minexia, who own and operate the NR Private Market platform. My background is in geology. I'm very much an exploration geologist at heart, although I've worked on a number of projects, you know, around the world and at various stages. And that's been terrific. But there's a real opportunity now with the platform to do something different, something innovative, and to try and hopefully get some finance into the junior sector, which you know, seems to be crying out for that right now.
And when looking at projects and potential offers, you refer to the four C's. Just tell me about these.
That's right. So in effect, it's a framework how we can establish a standard assessment protocol for looking at all the different projects. So we frame that around the four C's, as you say. That's the company, the concession, the commodity, and the country. For each one of those, we're looking at a range of criteria. The commodity is pretty self-explanatory, base metals, precious metals, exotics, the like, and there's plenty of those out there right now. Country-wise, what's the jurisdictional risk profile? Obviously, some countries sit wildly apart from one another in terms of those profiles. We have emerging jurisdictions and we have well-established jurisdictions, your Canada's, your Australia's and the like. In terms of the company, we're looking at where do they come from? The people who are involved, are they project developers? Are they explorers at heart? And what's their background? You know, have they got a pedigree, a history of bringing those projects through and ultimately generating value? And then it's the concession itself. So at that point, it is literally drilling down into the geology, looking to see what's there. Obviously, we see a variety of projects at different stages, exploration through to development. And therefore, it's looking at that project, not just the geology and whatever resource, you know, if they've got to that stage as well. But they're looking at the infrastructure, looking at some of the ESG considerations, the environment, logistics, for example, infrastructure. So where does that project stack up against its peers? Hopefully, there's a nice other project just upstrike that's already in production, so there's an analog. And using that framework, we can then, as I say, look at each one of those projects in isolation, but benchmark it against others.
You've got the GreenOre offer that's currently live on the
that's
platform
right.
at the moment. They've got a number of projects in Scotland, and you, of course, you've got a connection.
Absolutely, yeah. So it's great to see some homegrown talent coming onto the market. Gavin and his team have built up a portfolio of assets in Scotland, and having studied there and actually originating from Aberdeen and having worked in the oil sector, it's great to see something else happening in Scotland in the natural resources space. And I think this is just the start of the story.
Mm. And Gavin, of course, he's with me on Skype now. Gavin, good morning.
Morning, Andrew. How are you doing?
Good, thanks, Gavin. Look, tell me a bit more about your four main projects that you've got in Scotland.
So GreenOre have four main projects, Aberdeenshire, Perthshire, Ayrshire and Rossshire, all the shires. So we started out with Aberdeenshire initially in 2013 to look for gold and along the Dalradian trend. The idea with that was, because I've got the experience at Carnal Gold Deposit, we decided to look along trend along the Dalradian, and sure enough, we've seen a lot of gold occurrences along that trend. So we started off with Aberdeenshire. Perthshire is also on that trend. But since 2013, we've been evaluating the whole country and looking at all the historic gold occurrences, and that's where the other licenses have come from.
And three of these projects, I believe, are already under JVs, are they?
That's right. So we signed our first JV with COSA Limited in 2015 on the Aberdeenshire ground. And then subsequently, we took ground in Ayrshire, and we also signed a JV, a similar deal with COSA Limited in, I think it was 2016. And then our recent one in 2019, the end of 2019, is with Eris Resources. And that's on our Perthshire project.
And you're currently in a funding round at the moment with NR Private Marking, looking to raise to advance your fourth project. Is that correct?
That's right. That's right. So we've partnered up with nrprivatemarket.com, and we're looking to raise 600,000 for our Gearlock project, which is in Rossshire, and that's an historic copper gold deposit that was drilled in the 70s and the 80s. By the time was deemed uneconomic, but you know and I know that the prices of metals have dramatically changed since then. So I've taken a look at it. There's over 9,000 meters of drilling and no official resource has ever been calculated on it. So basically, I'm looking for 600,000 to do some confirmatory drill holes, do an official resource calculation on that, and then look to pre-feasibility.
Would the idea be to bring in a partner here also at some point?
Well, at some point, I mean, I would like to do it myself as much as I can. I mean, well-connected in the industry in Ireland, because I was originally a consultant for the last 13 years working with Orem Exploration and then working at Dalradian for the prior 2 years before setting up GreenOre. So I believe I've got the right people, the right minds together to, you know, take it as far as possible. But yeah, of course, we'll look at all options going forward.
And gold and base metals, that's the big focus for you.
Yeah, gold is the sexy element. Gold is always a good one. I mean, you can find a gold resource in a very small area. For an alt gold deposit, the majority of it is in a 1 kilometer squared area. So it's very easy for a gold deposit to be hiding anywhere. So gold is always good, but obviously copper is always good as well. Copper being, one of the main elements that's going to be, you know, more so in this green revolution that we're working towards. You know, a lot of the wind turbines that need copper, and a lot of the batteries and futures and electronics and that need copper. So, but we are looking at other elements as well.
What are you seeing as far as mining activity in Scotland? Are we seeing a bit of a pick up in pace there?
So, Scotland, I believe, have been at it for the last 20 years. They're really the only other company that's been active. There's been a couple of other companies that have been doing some work, but really, GreenOre, we hold the largest portfolio of metal projects in Scotland. We've diversified right around the country. We're in the Dalradian trend. We're also in Archean basement over on the west coast, and then down in the southern uplands, which is also a totally different geology and more connected across the water to maybe Conroy.
Mm. And tell me a bit more about the team that you've got there at GreenOre.
So it's myself and the other directors, Jim Finn and David Horgan, are part of the 162 group, and they've been instrumental in developing many companies. They've listed 15 companies on AIM. They've discovered a big, you know, one of the only hard rock diamond mines in Botswana. They were behind Kenmare Resources. So, it's a really good team. We've got Mark Sale, who brings a huge amount of experience from gold exploration and mine development around the world. And I've got some good guys on the ground. We're very keen, very excited to get going, and don't mind the weather.
So you're confident in the quality of your portfolio, and you're fairly keen to get out drilling.
I just want to get going. We've got the determination. We've got the will to go out and find, you know, Scotland's next gold mine.
Gavin, nice to speak with you. Thanks very much.
All right, Andrew. Nice to speak to you.
Gavin there from GreenOre, and Drew Cray from NR Private Market still with me in the studio. This, of course, your fifth deal here, and you're seeing the platform itself continuing to evolve.
Well, that's right. And we're listening to both the issuers and the investors that we're working with. Like any platform, it evolves over time, and we're trying to make it more user-friendly, easier to navigate through, and, you know, looking to augment the service as well, and so we have additional features coming online, such as the Investor Lounge, which is quite exciting. First companies just listed their profile there. That's B Metals. And there'll be future news coming out of that in due course.
Drew, good to meet you.
Thank you very much indeed.